I just make with the cutting tool here a groove, so I have the actually the length of the piston, but I notice it's a little bit wobbling around. But this is not good, because if you later drill the rust pin, it will be not exactly at 90 degrees. So now I must correct this. So I put my setup here, my micrometer, and this belt down. And if I turn it around, you can see that it's really moving up and down. So I first check which direction. I think this must be go up. Yes. Still a bit more. Oh, I think too much. Wrong way. No, that's wrong. I need a smaller hammer. So easy as it looks. Oops. That. Again. So sensitive. Okay, almost. Okay, this will do. 1/100. Okay, that's it. Clamp tighter together. Okay, that's it. Nice. And now I will drill out the inner side. When that is done, I will make the rust pin bore. And yeah, then we'll be cutting off. Okay, see you soon. So the finish grinding is okay. Now it's a really slight push fit. When the X-Tower's window closes, you must really push some more force. But I must not forget what's important is I will still polish the cylinder with metal polish, and I will polish the piston. So this will reduce also some material, and then it will go a little bit deeper. And a really last tiny thing of grinding, when you connect this together, you lap a little bit with very fine 1 micron pasta the piston to the finally last fit. And then I coat it with Teflon, liquid Teflon always, heat it up, so it will suck in the pores, and this will give a nice frictionless movement in the cylinder. So now I will drill out, and after this I will make the respin bore. Okay. So now I must find the center, but I saw something very interesting on YouTube. There was a guy shooting an old lathe trick, and this is very pretty simple, but works pretty good. You put a taper in a chuck, then a nice flat steel something. This is a feeler gouge. You put this between the drill of the tap, and if you move, it will do this or go down. So with this you can really pretty nicely find the center. And then you just use a reference line on the lathe, the prism or whatever, to visualize this line with something, and you will find a center like this. It should be here. Nice trick. I must remember this. You see? Must be, of course, the right pressure on it. Beware, of course, because I have some play here, so I must remember to put it on one or the other side, otherwise it will move. So nice. So our piston is almost ready. Only drill out the insides to get some weight reduction. And later I will also grind down on the low end and the higher top end a few thousandths to get a slightly barrel shape piston. This will allow of to prevent oil scrapping before the piston when it's moved up and down. So slightly barrel shape will allow to squeeze oil in it, and then you can have a tighter fit here, and it will not damage the liner and get a perfect fit. As the old Super Tiger engines take it a step further, they take something about like this from the skirt and reduces parallel, so it actually don't touch the piston or the liner, and it's only attach the oil to it to keep the adhesion of the oil. And this will make sure it gets lubricated and less friction, because on this part frictions with the cylinder and this part only catch the oil. But I will usually make this like a slightly barrel, but it's only a few thousandths smaller here and round to force the oil between this. So okay, now I will turn the inside. So I set it up in a collet, and now I must set up my milling compound, because actually this is like a drilling machine, but if you engage this block, I need more hands. If you engage this block, there is a gears, worm wheel, and it engage, and then you lock it, It's really clever from the Emco. And then if you have here a Scala, you can see this. And then you can actually control exactly how much you go down. And also another clever thing by the Emco 3. You have here a holder with a hexagonal screw. And if you put a pen inside, this comes with the Emco, you can block the amount of how much you go down. Lock it and it will only go down as far as this pen is here, because the steel plate will contact this here. So because I want to go down a little bit, maybe 0.2 millimeter deeper than the original piston, so to open up the transfer ports completely. Okay, I will try to do this on camera for you, 1 second. The original piston step is 0.6 millimeters, so I will go to 0.8. And that will open up the transfer port completely, I hope. So now I must zero in, of course, to my piston. Put it first here, lock my table. I go here on the scale to zero. This is about here. Actually, this, when it's up, it's pointing to zero, to this arrow. So now I must put it just a bit down. And always keep your tool as short as possible. So I can zero, and I open up a little bit so it goes down. So it's just scratch the surface. Lock it. Okay. And now I can check if it's correct. Little bit more, because this is actually very important size. No, it's too much. Okay, that's about good. Okay. Now I go 0.2. Four. Six. Eight. I'm also check my depth. This is about 0.7. So I go again down completely. Put the highest teeth on it. Also adjust this ring here, because I buy this special, so I can control this. I have these black ones, but they are not adjustable, and this one is adjustable, so this is really a great plus point. And now I can go back again to zero, and then 0.7. I forgot my play. Again. This is it. Okay. And two, four, I do first four. And then two, four, six. Six. And then the eight. So that's it, I hope. It's all very stressful stuff like this, because it's gonna ruin your work. But I think it looks good. Let's check how it looks. Yeah, I think it's okay. Camera will not focus, but it looks nice to me. So now I can remount the rust pin bore, take the small point down, and assemble it. Is now in a nice hot steamy bath to get rid of all the grinding compounds and metal chips and stuff. And I want to give you a last thing from me. I always use slick 50. This is liquid Teflon compound. You add this to your engine oil in a four-stroke engine, but a car engine. I find out that if I clean the engine very very nicely without any oil, add a few drops of the slick 50 and then turn around, heat it up, let it turn around with the hot oil of hot slick 50, and then let it cool down. And this will impregnate the metal structure, the surface of the engine, and then you get really a super smooth, frictionless movement inside the engine. And this is also perfect for running in the engine. You can also add a few drops into the fuel, and this will really give you a super very nice smooth turning engine. Of course, I polish all the surfaces like crankshaft and piston cylinder. If you polish this very up and impregnate it with slick 50, you get a really gain in RPM for sure. So this is something, one of my tricks. what a use. Just now waiting for the cleaning up and put them together. So, there we have it. Everything is together now. Oops. You have a nice pinch on top and center. Really perfect. And if you put it now on TDC, it will hold compression forever. So it's really great. And I make this lever for the carb, for open up the throttle. Because there was nothing there and you cannot just control where it stands. So now you can see what it's doing. Outside is open up. And yesterday I tried to run it and make a new needle because the needle has over too much play. And it, like you saw in the photos, it closed completely the ventury. This was also bad design. And now it's open up. And yesterday it almost run burst of one second and then it stops. But I know because the piston was not really tight enough, and when the mixture is rich, you get a lot of oil inside, so it seals. But when the engine starts, it burns off the fuel, it leans out and then it starts leaking, and then they drop the compression and then it stops. But now it's really nice pitch on the top and I'm sure it will run. So soon I will test this now. It's very smooth now. I'm confident now also the step lower now, that you can get more fresh gas inside, so it must actually run, and even better than before, I think. It's actually strange because these main engines were made by in Russia, I think, by VA engines. All CNC and everything is perfect. I never saw a bad one. So maybe it was only a compression issue, but as the transfer port is only open up 60%, so it never hurts to open up 100. So now it's for sure okay. Okay, let's try to run it soon. So, there it is, the big mills. I just fill it up, just once a few seconds before. It's a bit difficult to find the right adjustments for compression, because it's very fast overcompressed, but it runs. There we go. Lovely. Sensitive, but it runs. Sensitive for this. Lovely.